with the Reverend Dr. Claude Apex as our senior pastor. You can view us on our Facebook page, St. Paul CME Church, to see the service. We hope you enjoy.
My beloved, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I was so glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord one more time on this Sunday, this day of Pentecost. As we begin our Pentecost season, we greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We welcome you here this morning to the St. Paul CME Church, Jackson, Tennessee, Lane College campus here, and on our online praise and worship service this morning. To God be the glory for the things he has done, even in the midst of this pandemic, this COVID-19, in the midst of a horrible tragedy, death of Mr. George Floyd. God is still good, and God has made a way out of no way. And so we greet you here today to be a part of this worship service. Join in with us Facebook Live, and you may also join and listen audio on our conference call number. We thank God for you, those of you across the country, across America, who share with us every week. We thank you for your presence. We are here every week and on Sunday morning, and we are here every Wednesday for our Bible study at 6:15. Amen. And we thank God for your being faithful to us here at the St. Paul Church. God is so good. Let us pray, my brothers and sisters. Oh God, we come today in the midst of all that has taken place this week, all of the things that have happened, we have experienced. We pray, oh God, especially for the family of George Floyd in Minneapolis, Minnesota. We pray, oh God, that you comfort and sustain them. And Lord, we know that there have been protests and all over America. And Lord, we pray, oh God, for protection and that no harm and danger comes to others, that we learn how to be nonviolent in the midst of a violent society. Lord, we thank you for all that you've done and will do. Bless this service, this moment, this word that will go forth, that we might help and heal and bless and give somebody some hope for this day, for this morning. In the name of Jesus, we come right now in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 I am your humble servant, Claude A. Bass, the pastor here and the presiding elder of the Southwest District. To God be the glory for all that he has done. My brothers and my sisters, we invite your attention to, as part of our Hebrew reading for this day of Pentecost, as we deal with the Holy Spirit. But we invite your attention to the Old Testament, the Hebrew Bible, the Hebrew reading in the book of Numbers, chapter 11. Numbers, chapter 11. Amen. Join in with us. Send us some hearts of love. Let us know you're with us. The book of Numbers, chapter 11. Amen. We hope that you can hear us and all of that. The book of Numbers, chapter 11, amen. And we want to begin reading just at the 24th verse. And in your reading, you may read the entire 11th chapter of Numbers, but we want to begin today at the 24th verse. And the English Standard Version of the Bible says, "So Moses went out and told the people the words of the Lord. And he gathered 70 men of the elders of the people and placed them around the tent. Then the Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to him and took some of the spirit that was on him and put it on the 70 elders. And as soon as the spirit rested on them, they prophesied, but they did not continue doing it. Now two men remained in the camp, one named Eldad and the other named Medad, and the spirit rested on them. They were among those registered, but they had not gone out to the tent or the tabernacle, and so they prophesied in the camp. And a young man ran and told Moses, "Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp." And Joshua, the son of Nun, the assistant of Moses from his youth, said, "My Lord Moses, stop them." But Moses said to him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all that the Lord's people were prophets, that the Lord would put his spirit on them." And Moses and the elders of Israel returned to the camp. Amen, amen, amen. And so in this passage, the main text, verses 24 and 26, says, "So Moses went out and told the people the words of the Lord. And he gathered 70 men of the elders of the people and placed them around the tent. And then the Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to him and took some of the spirit that was on him and put it on the 70 elders. And as soon as the spirit rested on them, they prophesied, but they did not continue doing it. Now two men remained, they all right, in the camp, one named Eldad and the other named Medad, and the spirit rested on them. And they were among those registered, but they had not gone out to the tent, and so they prophesied in the camp." Amen. So we want to talk about this morning, today, on this day of Pentecost. We want to talk about that. Hopefully you can see it on the screen. We want to use this thought: Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. The Spirit of God needs to rest on the church. Amen. The moving of God's word, or if you will, the performance of God's word. Amen. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Amen, amen, amen. And so, my brothers and my sisters, today, as we look around in America and the world, there's a great need for the Holy Spirit to fall fresh on every Christian and child of God. It's a need. We need the Spirit of the living God to do what? To anoint us, to guide us, and to protect us. especially as we are now at the beginning of the day of Pentecost for the Christian church. And the text in Acts chapter 2, verse 1 through 4 states, when the day of Pentecost arrived, they were all together in one place. And suddenly there came from heaven a sound like a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. And divided tongues as a fire appeared to them and rested, you see that, on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Amen. There's a great need for the church and for all of us to have the Spirit of God to refresh us, to fall on us. And so in the midst of this pandemic, the Word of God and the Spirit of God must come down on the church, must come down on us, just as it did in our text in the book of Numbers of chapter 11, verses 24, you can go back to verse 16 through 30. We find the performance of God's word to Moses that he should have help in the government of Israel. In other words, if you read the beginning of Numbers chapter 11, you'll discover that the folks were complaining about being delivered from Egypt and how they ate better food and they were all taken care of. And here they were now in the wilderness and all they had was manna from on high. And so they complained to the pastor, to the preacher, to the leader, Moses, that they would have should have stayed. And so Moses prayed for them, and he prayed to God to ask the Lord to do something about it. And so as you read on, you'll find and discover. And so what happens is, we come on down through the chapter, the Lord told Moses what to do. He said, go get 70 elders and bring them to the camp, because I see you need some help. Amen, somebody. I see you need some help in order to lead these folk. And so he said, go get them, and I'll set them here so I can bless them and put the Spirit of God on them. And so here is the case in this text of the 70 elders, the privy counselors in general, if you will. And so we recognize in this text, one of the things we first recognize is God must communicate with the leader or the pastor first, or to prepare them, the folk, for the sharing of God's word. Amen. God, all you need to read all through there, God always spoke to Moses. He spoke to the leader. And so God must communicate with that leader, with that shepherd first, to prepare them for the sharing of God's word. So it says in verse 24 of the text, it says, so Moses went out and told the people the words of the Lord. And he gathered 70 men of the elders of the people and placed them around the tent. Oh yeah, what are you saying, Pastor? So Moses, though he was a little disturbed by the complaining of the people and the church folk, if you will, yet he became composed and cool because the communion that he had with God. And he soon came to himself. What are you saying? Well, in spite of all that was going on and the complaining, every now and then when you have an opportunity to talk with God, amen, somebody, whatever you're going through, whatever you're facing in life, it ought to bring some kind of calmness. Lord have mercy to your situation. If you are allowed to talk with him. And so Moses had a time that he would spend with God. He had been talking with God throughout this chapter, if you read, and throughout the time. And so every now and then that calmed him down. Amen. That made him be able to, he soon came to himself. And even today, in the midst of what we are going through, if you have a little talk, let me make it go home a little closer. If you have a little talk with Jesus and tell him all about it, he'll come and he'll come. Even though the world around you is in chaos, even though there are protests and there's violence, there's murder, and all of that is taking place, there's racism, there's poverty, there's unemployment. But if I could just have a little talk with Jesus and tell him all about it, it'll make you calm. I hope I'm helping somebody here today on Facebook Live or wherever you are, in your living room, your bedroom, your kitchen. And so what happens is that Moses did his part. See, you got to do your part when God wants to use you and bless you. He presented the 70 elders before the Lord. And that's what he did. And round the tabernacle and round the tent, that they might stand there ready to receive the grace of God. Ready to receive the Spirit of God. The word of God. And so he presented the 70. He said, Lord, I'm doing what you told me to do. Here they are, the 70 that you told me to do, what to do. And so here it is. The next thing is, my brothers and sisters, the next thing is, if you're writing this down, is the fulfillment of God's word to Moses and the 70 elders and the church. There took place a fulfillment of God's word to Moses and the 70 elders and the church. The Spirit, in other words, the Spirit of God came down. Amen. Because you know God is up and God got to reach down to get to us. Hello, somebody. And the Spirit came down. Verse 25 of the text. I hope you got your Bible, your iPad, your iPhone, whatever it takes. The verse 25 says in the text, and the Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to him and took of the Spirit that was all upon him and put it on the 70 elders. And when the Spirit rested upon them, they prophesied, Lord have mercy, sounding forth the praises of God and declaring his will. Then they did so no more. And so this is the fulfillment of God's word. And as God spoke to them through the cloud and spoke to him, the Spirit that was upon him, it came on the others. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Every now and then, the Spirit of God will fall fresh on somebody else. If it's only you sometime, you can share it with somebody else. And so the Spirit came down and rested on them. Oh, yes. And so here it is. The next thing we need to notice in this text is that sometimes we underestimate the power of God's Spirit in our lives. Sometimes we underestimate, we take it for granted, the power of God's Spirit in our lives. Amen. Oh yeah, verse 26 of the text. verse 26 of the text says to us here, but there remained two men in the camp named Eldad and Medad, and the Spirit rested upon them. And they were of those who were selected and listed. Yet they did not go out to the tent as told to do, but they prophesied in the camp. Amen. And so sometimes we must not underestimate the power of God's word. What might happen here in this verse 26 about these two remained, the man who remained in the camp, named Eldad and Medad. They were brothers, two elders, brothers, sensible of their own weaknesses and unworthiness. They were aware, and you ought to be aware that whoever you are in the church and wherever you come from, that you ought to recognize you got some weaknesses. Amen, somebody. You are unworthy to be serving in the church. And who had not attended the presentation ceremony, they didn't go with the rest of the elders to the tabernacle. And so they prophesied in the same manner as the other elders. They exercised their gift of praying and their gift of preaching and praising God in some camp. Amen. And so this demonstrates to us, Lord help us, that God's Spirit cannot be confined to any space and time, but the Spirit of God found them in the camp. The Spirit found them out. And so what are you saying, preacher? I'm saying that the Holy, nobody holds a monopoly on the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is free. The wind blows and you know, don't know where it listeth and where it come from. And so it's available to everybody. And you'd be a fool to underestimate the power of God, even though these two didn't go with the rest of them. God let his Spirit rest on them. I'm trying to help somebody in here. Those of us who feel like they are not ready, they're not available, that God can't use them. God can call anybody to do his work and his ministry. Oh, yes, there was a special providence in it that these two, Eldad and Medad, should be absent from the other elders at the tabernacle. Moses, you know, Moses didn't give these two the Spirit. But that's all right. Somebody ain't got to tell or bless you with anything. But God gave the Spirit to them. God gave the Spirit to Eldad and Medad. There's some Eldad and Medads around the church, around America, around everywhere. There's some that somebody don't have to pat you on the back, don't have to give you their word to say who you are. I want you to know God is looking at you. And so God gave the Spirit to them. And the Spirit of God is not confined to the tabernacle. Lord have mercy. The Spirit of the words, you know, we are here today in our pandemic. And a lot of our churches are empty like this one this morning. But I want you to know that today that the Spirit of God is not confined to this sanctuary. If I go down the street, I can find God's Spirit. If I go to the top of the mountain, I can find God's Spirit and his word. Everywhere I go, even if you're in a dark place, God's Spirit will meet you there. Lord, have mercy. Oh, yes, God's Spirit can be found. And I've got to move at the camp anywhere and be given to anyone. The Spirit found them hidden among the stuff. Yeah, let me say that again. The Spirit of God found them hidden among the stuff. What are you saying, Pastor? Sometimes God's Spirit can find you even in the midst of a mess. I don't know what trouble you're in. I don't know what mess you're in, but I do know we all in the midst of a pandemic. We're all in trouble around here today, and we all have to wear our mask and wear our gloves and wash our hands, and we're isolated. But I just wanted to remind you and give you some hope here on this day of Pentecost that God's Spirit can find you in the midst of the mess. Lord, have mercy. And so these two men prophesied, even though they had not joined the other elders at the tabernacle. They were not obedient, but neither were they presumptuous or overconfident or arrogant. And the Lord showed that he still wanted them as leaders, as elders in the government of Israel. I just want to remind somebody here today in your house, wherever you are right now, that God still wants you. God still needs you to serve and work in the church. God still needs you in the ministry of the church. Let me move. I don't want to keep you here long this morning. But some information doesn't need to be told in the church. Lord have mercy. What do you say? Sometimes some information, a message doesn't need to be told in your family, in your business. Some things you just need to keep, don't say anything. What do you say, Pastor? Look at verse 27 of Numbers chapter 11. Verse 27 says, and a young man ran to Moses and said, Eldad and Medad are prophesying, sounding forth the praises of God and declaring his will in the camp. My brothers and sisters, whoever the person was that brought the information to Moses must have thought it to be out of place, or thought it might outdo Moses. Oh yeah, they were so eager. You know how we do. Sometimes we want to run and tell the pastor something about somebody else. I'm trying to help somebody in here. Don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. Sometimes we want to go and tell our bishops and other folks certain things about other folks. But whoever the person was, they brought this misinformation to Moses. They thought they were doing the right thing. But Joshua moved to have them silenced. Amen. He moved to have them silenced. In verse 28 of the text, it says, Joshua, son of Nun, the minister of Moses, one of his chosen men, said, my Lord Moses, forbid them. In other words, make them be quiet. He does not want to punish them for praying and preaching like they were doing, for prophesying, but only restrain them for the future. Maybe he was concerned about them getting in the way of Moses and taking his job. Hello, somebody. But I just wanted to remind you that whatever's for you, God has it for you. Whatever God wants you to do, God will make sure you'll be able to do it. You ain't got to worry about nobody else. And so, my brothers and sisters, bring me to say, after Joshua moved to have them silenced, this brings me to say, as a leader, as an elder, as a child of God, you can't listen to bad advice. Amen. I'm trying to help somebody this week. Oh yeah, we've been watching all on the news, bad advice, this and that. You cannot listen to bad advice. Verse 29 of the text, and I'm almost done here today. Verse 29 says, but Moses said to him, are you envious or jealous for my sake? Would that the Lord's people were prophets, and that the Lord would put his spirit upon them. Oh yes. It even deals with that in Luke chapter 9, verse 49. Moses, in other words, Moses, if you will, rejected the motion in the conference and checked him that made it. Lord have mercy. He said, no, I'm not going to honor that motion. I'm not going to bother these two elders. They're just as good as anybody else. They're doing the Lord's work. They just didn't come down to the conference at the tabernacle. You know how it is in the church. Everybody can't make it to the meeting. But God always got somebody who still will do his will. And so we must not be so quick to condemn and silence those that differ from us. We must not be so quick to put folks down that don't talk like us, that don't look like us. And so Moses rejected their motion. And as if they did not follow Christ, because they do not follow him with us. Everybody don't worship like you. Everybody doesn't praise God like you. Everybody doesn't do just like you. And so everybody has their own way, and we not all condemn other folks. We can't afford to condemn other denominations, other faiths, as long as they're serving God and serving Christ. And so, my brothers and sisters, yes, and it's if they don't follow Christ because they do not follow him with us. The Bible says in Mark chapter 9, verse 38, it says, John said to him, Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us. But Jesus said, do not stop him, for no one who does a mighty work in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Lord have mercy. Shall we reject those who Christ has owned and claimed, or restrain any from doing good because they are not in everything of our mind? Everybody don't think like you. If we have the mind of Christ, let this mind be in Christ that was also in you. And Moses was from another spirit. He wasn't like the rest of them, those pseudo-intellectuals who were always ready to look down their noses at folk. You know how they are. We got them in the church today. We got them in the government. We got them everywhere. We got them in politics. Moses was from another spirit. So far from shutting up these two, he didn't want to shut them up, Eldad and Medad, and quenching the spirit in them. Who do you think you are that you can quench the spirit in somebody else? If somebody feel like shouting, let them shout. If somebody want to praise God, let them praise God. Whoever they are, because you don't know their story. You don't know what they've been through. You don't know what they've been through and came through. All of us are in the midst of a pandemic, but you don't know their story. You don't know if they're working every day and got food on their table. You don't know their story. And if they want to shout and praise God because he's been so good to them, you ought to get out their way. And so Moses was from another spirit. He didn't want to quench the spirit in them. What are you saying, preacher? He wishes all the Lord's people were prophets. Yes. Lord have mercy. I don't know. I agree with Moses. I wish everybody could say a word for the Lord, that the Lord would put his spirit on them. Yes. And so, my brothers and sisters, bring me to say to you this morning, when the Lord sends his spirit and ordains you for ministry, you are ready to go to work. When the Lord's Spirit comes upon you and ordains you for ministry, you are ready to go to work. The Bible says in the text in verse 30, And Moses and the elders of Israel returned to the camp. They left the conference. They left their meeting with the presiding officer Moses and went back to the camp. I imagine where the folks were there, the ordinary people, and where Eldad and Medad had remained, taking care of the business of the church while the others were away. They went back to the camp. Well, I'm sure they found some who were still in burden bound. They went back to the camp. Well, I'm sure they found some who still needed some healing in their body. They went back to the camp. But I'm sure they found some who were in the midst of a pandemic or COVID-19. I want to tell you, somebody here today, after you leave the seminary, after you leave the annual conference, after you leave your district conference in Methodism, after you leave the Baptist convention, wherever you've been, I want to remind somebody, you got to go back, the Lord have mercy, to the camp where you'll find Aunt Jane waiting on a word from the Lord, where you'll find Uncle Joe needs some help in the time of a storm, where you'll find some boy or girl who needs a helping hand. And so the elders, now newly ordained, they immediately entered on their administration. And when their call was sufficiently attested by their prophesying, they went with Moses to the camp. They went with Moses back to the church folk and applied themselves to ministry and applied themselves to business. What are you saying, preachers? I get ready to get out your way this morning. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us, because we need somebody every now and then. If we're in the midst of this time of a storm, let the example of Moses be followed by those in power. Let them not despise the advice and assistance of others, but desire it and be thankful for it. If all the present number of the Lord's people were rendered prophets or ministers by the Spirit of Christ, though not all agree in outward matters, there's work enough for all of us. And in calling sinners to repentance and faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Come, Holy Spirit, with all of our quickening power and kindle the flame. I don't want to hoop here today, but I feel a preach coming on. Excuse me, Lord. I'm closing here now. We thank you for all you chiming in today. We give God the glory. We give God the praise. Oh, yes, Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Yes, the Spirit of God needs to rest on the church. We need a moving of God's word. We need God's word to come, especially here on this May 31st, 2020. The Spirit of God needs to come and be a part of us and fall on us in our homes, in our families, in our churches, on our pastors, everywhere. People need to hear a word from the Lord. And as we move forward in this Pentecost season, let the Holy Ghost set you on fire to do God's will. This is our message to you today. We thank you for chiming in with us at the St. Paul CME Church, Jackson, Tennessee, Lane College campus. We thank you for your presence, sharing with us here today. And say, we say to you, have a blessed week. May God be with you. And if you want to bless this ministry, you may do so through Givelify. You may do so through mail. You may do so by coming by on Sunday morning and receiving it. Your offering you may give at the door. We thank you, O God, for all that you've done. We pray and hope that somebody has been helped today. And so we have spoken here today, and God give the glory, and the church must say amen. And so we say to you, my brothers and sisters, wherever you are across the country, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon each and every one of you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace right now and forevermore. And the people of God said amen. Join us next this Wednesday coming for Bible study 6:15. Amen. God bless you.
Enjoy today's service and give our thanks for attending. Join us again next Sunday for St. Paul Online Campus Live Show. Remember this, Hebrews says, whatever life brings, we can be assured that the one who rescued us from our greatest foe stands ready to help us in our times of greatest need. Enjoy your week and stay blessed.